Hello everyone, this is Sam Spade, and welcome to the start of another tutorial series, which I'm calling an unnecessarily long series about alarms in GameMaker Studio 2.3. You might think that you could cover alarms in GameMaker Studio 2.3 in a minute or two at most, and you'd be right, but somehow this is still going to take several videos. So why is that? Why should you watch an unnecessarily long tutorial series about alarms? Well, first, you might watch it so that you learn about the various ways that you can make or implement an alarm in GameMaker Studio 2.3. I'm going to go through several different ways about how to make alarms. Each will be in its own short video and talk about the pros and cons of that method. But second, and more importantly, I really want to use these videos to provide a framework for understanding, using, and building systems. So while we are going to cover alarms and various ways to use them, the goal will be to use these alarms as a lens for thinking about systems, and more importantly, how to understand, interact with, build, evaluate, design systems, not just alarms, but any system. And so I want to leave you with four questions in two sets of two. The first set is, what is an alarm? And by this, I don't mean what is an alarm in code. I mean, if someone walked up to you on the street and said, what is an alarm? What would your response be? What's a good general definition of an alarm? Second, how do you interact with an alarm? So think of some real alarms in your life. How do you interact with them? One example might be that you set them. The second set of questions is a rephrasing of these first two. The first one is, what should an alarm be? If you were making an alarm, what would your ideal alarm look like? And the next question is, how would you like to interact with an alarm? Again, if you were making an alarm, what would you want to be able to do with it? And with that, I'm going to end this introduction. And that's it. Thanks for watching.